Hello, I'm Gerard and you're on Creative PowerPoint. Today, I'd like to show you my workflow to create this animated 3D smartphone in PowerPoint. This will give me the opportunity to present you a magic trick to work more easily with 3D models in PowerPoint. To build my 3D model, I started by creating 2D shapes that represent the different parts seen from the top. During this step, I only kept the shapes outlined to better see how the shapes are positioned relative to each other. To create the Maple logo, I used an icon from Microsoft stock. After you've completed this step, you should see something similar as what I have on my screen. We have created the outline, but before we can add any volume, we need to do some housekeeping and give all those shapes a name. So I went to the selection pane, double-clicked on all the shapes one by one, and gave to each of them a meaningful name. And now it's time for me to reveal the magic trick. By the way, if you like this video, don't forget to push the like button so that more people can see it. So, here's the magic trick. I selected all the shapes and combined them into a single group. With this trick, you are telling PowerPoint that all those shapes belong to a single 3D object and it should rotate them together. Pretty easy, huh? So, what should we do next? Here was my workflow. I selected all the shapes one by one, starting by the one at the frontmost, in our case, the screen. For every of those shapes, I set the correct fill color and removed the outline. Then I set any bevel or depth. My screen being flat, there was neither bevel nor depth to set, so I skipped to the second shape in order. The second shape is a smartphone body. I selected it, set a fill color and removed the outline. Then I went to the effects tab, and in the 3D format section, added a round bevel at the front and another round bevel at the back. To see more easily what I was doing, I selected the whole group and in the effects tab, under the 3D rotation section, rotated the whole group. You may also notice that the different parts of the smartphone are moving together. For example, you can see that the volume buttons stay on the side of the phone. And that's because I put them all in the same group just before. You can already see the smartphone taking shape. Now, I would like to add some depth to the volume and power buttons and position them correctly on the side of the smartphone. As you can see, the volume buttons were visible, but the power button was hidden behind the phone body. To select the three buttons, I went to the selection pane and selected the three objects by name. Hold the command or control key to add multiple objects to your selection. Then, I reduced the distance from the ground to minus 4 points and gave the button a depth of 2 points. I've made a video earlier to explain the basics of 3D in PowerPoint, including the concept of distance from ground. If you want to know more about this, I'll give the link at the end of this video. Finally, I set a fill color to the buttons and removed the outline. To see my current result from another angle, I selected my group and rotated it in 3D space. I realized I wanted my power and volume buttons to be smaller, so I selected them and nudged them by a couple of pixels with my arrow keys. You can see it's progressing, but we still need to move the camera, the lens, and the Maple logo to the back. I selected my group again and rotated it to see the back of my phone. Then, in the selection pane again, I selected the logo, the lens, and the camera, and reduced the distance from ground to push them to the back. The body has a front and a back bevel of 6 points each, so I needed to push those shapes to minus 12 points to start seeing them again at the back of the phone. Then, it was time to add the camera bevel. I selected the camera and set a back bevel. To see the bevel, I needed to set a fill color. I also removed the outline. Then I needed to push the lens further to the back. Since the camera bevel had a height of 6 points, I needed to reduce the distance from ground of the lens by 6 points, ending up in a distance from ground of minus 18 points. Then I removed the outline of the lens and added a black fill. Here's one advice, if you try to ungroup the object, PowerPoint can get confused and end up creating all this mess. As I walk around, reset all rotation values before you ungroup the object. Let's now animate the smartphone. I selected the group containing the smartphone and rotated it in 3D space. Then I duplicated my slide and on the second slide, I rotated the group to another angle. Then I added a morph transition to the second slide. Here's what that transition looks like. I hope this tutorial will help you build fantastic 3D objects in PowerPoint, and if not done yet, I encourage you to look at this other video where I explain all the fundamentals of 3D in PowerPoint. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care!